Welcome to the Grok Shop. You're witnessing a deterioration of an ant trail in my garage using some concoction I brewed up. And today I want to talk about these ants that I'm dealing with. They're called Linepithema Humile or Humile. And they're also known as Argentine ants. And credit to these images in the description below that I'm using, but you can see it's turned into a worldwide problem, and in red here you can see where they spread in the US. They're a particular problem because of the way that they've attacked agriculture. They actually farm aphids. They kill ladybugs, which kill aphids, and they also wipe out native ant colonies in a pretty massive way. And this results in a certain native species not being able to find the grub they normally get, so in that way it disrupts the overall food chain. One thing about the species is they come from an area that's very high in humidity and moisture, and they do prefer a very moist environment. So in the summertime in Southern California, you may see that they come out a lot. Because it becomes so dry, they come out looking for water mainly, but they do also come out looking for food, and foods they like include sweet stuff, oily, protein-based stuff, and we'll use some of that to our advantage here in a minute. So yeah, I've been showing some good information I found on the web, and I particularly like this book by Moffat, Adventures Among Ants. I highly recommend you check it out. I've checked it out in the online archive.org here, but it's got great information. The Argentine Ant chapter was very informative. I've also been in contact with David Holloway, a researcher at UCSD, about the warring super colonies. So when I first started battling these ants, I was using the Taro Ant Killer. It was the best one I found, and it was pretty effective, but the cost was kind of high. So basically, I did my best to reverse engineer what they did, and knowing that boric acid, you know, is the main ingredient, and a certain level of sugar is needed, I did some research on the right proportions, and basically proceeded to make my own ant killer in mass quantities, because I have a lot of land to defend. But if you don't have the time, I definitely recommend the Taro. It's a good product. This is just a more cost-effective approach for bigger problems. Now, the key point to remember when using this boric acid sugar mixture is you don't want to make it so toxic that the ants die right away upon ingesting the mixture. What you want is a mildly toxic solution that allows them to carry that back to the queens and thereby wipe out the whole nest. And the queens actually come out. You'll see them sometimes. The unique feature about this species is there's multiple queens per colony, and these queens don't have wings or anything. They're about 2 to 3 times bigger than the standard worker Argentine ant. But the idea is to have the ideal level of toxicity, and I think I've gotten pretty close with this formula here, and I'll post up the formula here in a minute. But pretty much all the ingredients I'm showing here are just sugar and boric acid. And the stuff I have is called Roach Prufe, but you can get your boric acid in all kinds of different forms. Definitely don't buy the stuff at the drugstore, which is pharmaceutical grade or whatever. Just you want the standard boric acid stuff. And then what I do is I make it in a 6-ounce batch, and I have the right proportions for 6 ounces. Here you can see I'm using a 6-ounce jam jar. Dickens strawberry jam, I think it was. Pretty good stuff. Highly recommend that. Now, to make everything dissolve really well, make sure you use hot water. And I find it easier just to pour the dry ingredients in first, then pour the hot water on top, and then give it a good shake. By the way, if you're thinking about using insecticides for these ants, just forget it. It's very ineffective, and additionally, of course, that's environmentally unsound. So this is definitely the way to go. It pretty much goes without saying, but be sure your sugar that you're using for this is isolated from the sugar you use for cooking and whatnot. You wouldn't want to pass back from the boric acid into your food. I think it's mildly toxic. It won't kill you probably, but I mean, unless you ate a lot of it, just don't do that. Okay, once you've got your potion all mixed up, ready to go, you need to think about your deployment containers. What I use is these little baby food bottles. I punch some holes in the top for the ants to be able to get in and out. And it's pretty effective because it maintains the humidity and prevents a fast evaporation. I mean, it will eventually evaporate. But if it's evaporating at that rate, you probably aren't killing many ants. So it'll last for some days in these jars. There are some drawbacks to the jars. The biggest of which is if you don't have a way to put the jar against the ant line that's coming in at a certain angle where they can easily get to it, some of the ants won't go through the trouble of trying to climb up a jar that's laying sideways on the ground or top way. So in certain situations, you may want to take a cap and just throw some in there, or even drip some on the floor. As I showed in that earlier time-lapse video, these ants will demolish stuff that's dripped on the floor from this concoction. And they'll do it in no time, and you won't have anything left. There's no sticky stuff. It's pretty amazing. Of course, when you find ants in your house, you want to battle them in your house, but then you want to take the battle outside the house, find out where they're coming in, and get busy protecting your perimeter. And one last time-lapse video for y'all here, showing me doing just that. Now, when fighting these ants outside, one thing to keep in mind is they prefer to hunt at night when it's cool. When the sun comes out, they'll thin right out, but that doesn't mean the battle's over. Leave your concoction out for at least another night, as I'll do here, and they will return, and then after that, should be no more ants. There you have it. That's how it's done. Thanks for watching.